Hi, I'm Jason Matthews, owner of Matthews Painting Company in Warsaw, Indiana. We continue our tutorial videos that we show each new employee who are training to become a professional painter. Today we're simply going to talk about extension cords and how we store extension cords on these rolls that are made for keeping anywhere from a 25-foot to 100-foot extension cord. We typically have 50 and 100-foot in the companies. As you can tell, we always inspect the cords. We make sure there's no frays in them and they're not twisted. We also make sure that we don't see any of the inside wires here at either end. We've checked the female side, which is sitting behind the camera. You might say that does not look like a regular male end. You are correct. We actually repaired this one, but you do have to make sure it is a UL approved male end or female end, whichever one you're replacing, so that it passes OSHA's standards. What we do though is we always come in here. If we could come in a little closer, you'll notice we've got slots here. Some are a little larger for a larger gauge extension cord, and this is a little bit of a smaller hole here. But we always bring the male end in and through, and we go out about 10 inches, I would say, and click it into that slot. So we just click it into that slot there, and we start winding up the cord. You're gonna see at the end of this video, if you wanna step back and watch me wind this, you'll see at the end of this video why we actually choose the male end to actually be in the slot there. So I'm gonna go ahead and get this wound up. Might as well have the seat because this is gonna take a little while. It takes a little bit of time because it does get in the way a little bit as you're kind of winding this up. If you want to do it by hand, that's another way. Some folks like to do this instead of using this knob that's on the side. Usually you're not taking an extension cord completely off and completely on interior jobs because you don't need 50 or 100 foot. That would be more for exterior jobs where you're actually needing it for a sprayer. So this looks like it's going to be a little bit easier to do it by hand because that male end that's hanging out keeps slapping around. So we've got about 100 foot here, so give me about 30 seconds and I'll have this wound up. Again, always inspecting your cord as you're winding them up is very important. If any cord is frayed in the middle, I would just recommend completely throwing away the cord and buying new. However, again, you can always get a new end, female or male adapter, UL approved, at a local Ace Hardware, or an electrician could do that for you. So once we're wound up, I'm going to show you why we like to have this male end sticking out. If you can come over here to an outlet, it's just a nice area there to just plug in, and you can just let your actual roll sit here. Why do I like that? Because if I only need about 10 foot of my cord here, I can just unravel what I need. I don't have to carry this heavy roll all over the place, and then I can just walk out, use this wherever with a work light or anything else I might need power for, like a shop vac and something like that. Thank you for watching our video. Again, Jason with Matthews Painting Company. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us, 574-834-3575, or our website at matthewspainting.com.